posed by the re-examiner leave the court with the impression of the facts derived from the witness that is capable of being construed unfavorably to the side responsible for calling the witness, and that represents a distortion or an incomplete account of the truth as the witness is able to represent it, then the witness can be re-examined about it. Lord, this court has already said that the further better particulars are not evidence, but pleadings. And we are seeking to tender it to give the full picture of the contents of the further and better particulars, as only half the truth has been told in the evidence that is before the court. The respondents will suffer no surprise, as I've said earlier, because they are very much aware of the further and better particulars, and it will assist the court in clearing the air on what information has been provided by the petitioners.
A quick matter of law. I suppose when it comes to matters that are covered by our legislation, resort to common law decisions, I think are quite irrelevant. And the relevant provisions as contained in the Evidence Act of 1975 at section 73 is quite clear as to the scope of re-examination. And if you love to permit me, I'll read that. So subject to the discretion of the court, re-examination shall be directed to the explanation of matters referred to in cross-examination. That's the first one. And then B, a matter cannot be re-examined or otherwise further examined as to the same matter raised by examining party on previous examination without leave granted by court in his discretion. But the witness may be re-examined or otherwise further examined as to any new matter upon which he has been examined by another party. So clearly, re-examination as of right only arises when it's a new matter, contrary to the authorities that Malene has read, that where one can re-examine a witness as a matter of right, that must arise to something new that has arisen during cross-examination. Now, what counsel is seeking to do, in my understanding, is that it's now seeking leave to re-examine a matter that is not new. And my respectful submission is that it is merely a disguised attempt, as it were, to rehash matters in respect of which explanation has been given and the answers given in respect of questions are concise. There is no ambiguity here. And your lordships had earlier given a ruling when my learned senior tried to even tender matters that were contained in affidavits before this court in relation to the 22 polling stations. And your lordship's opinion was very clear that that is on record already. It's an amazing suggestion indeed that what is considered as pleading is being sought to be tendered. I think it's completely inappropriate.
Lord, I would also just briefly add that this is a matter on which we had earlier pleaded that we had not received the full complement of the 11,000 odd exhibits, my Lord. And as far back as 27th of February, in paragraph 18 of our second amended answer, this reading was made, my Lord. So it is not a matter that first came up in cross-examination.
I may also just add that the pleadings in respect of the further and better particulars that were ordered by your lordship were responded to in terms that were documented before the court. And those documents before the court need no further tendering in evidence or being, they are already part of the record of this court.
If it's part of the record, I wonder why Anan Senta opposes it. And again, counsel for second respondent has indicated what we were saying, that he says the further and better particulars does not contain all the information that we are certain it contains. So we think it is a matter that should be tendered for this court to have a look at it and see whether what we are saying is true or not, because it goes to the credibility of the witness. They will not be overreached by the tendering of this document because they all have it. My Lord, if we can be gathered by the reasons of the Olympics,
we just give one. The pleadings are already part of the record and their tender in evidence is out of place.
Very well. That's the reason, that's fine. Dr. Barnier. During cross-examination, you told the court that you are no longer relying on all the 11,842 polling stations, and that you have deleted from that list 704 polling stations. Now, all attempts by you to give a list of these 704 polling stations were resisted by a council for respondents. Now, do you have the list with you?
Objection. The witness was very clear about the time when he was testifying, when he had deleted polling stations that they did not require for this case. And that evidence was given under examination in chief. In fact, during examination in chief, he was permitted to tender a revised analysis based on the polling stations that he said he had deleted. And in that, pursuant to that, he delivered to this court as exhibit a list of polling stations that he said they were no longer going to rely on. And this was when he was leading a understanding. But Lord, if the witness had this material before the commencement of trial, he ought to, during the time he was giving his evidence in chief, given that to the court. Being confronted in cross-examination with material that he has supplied, which shows numerous duplications, what they are trying to do is to clean up the table. And I think that is not part of the scope of re-examination. The opportunity was there when he was testifying and examination. This is not a matter that they can use cross-examination to re-interview. It's my respectful submission that any attempt to introduce in re-examination a matter that, according to the witness's own testimony, he had knowledge of at the time that he was examining chief is wrongful. It's completely inappropriate. And that they cannot be allowed to tender that analysis that he kept referring to, because he must have had that analysis when he was testifying in chief. Maybe he can autograph the analysis when we finish, and I'll be happy to take it. But as part of these proceedings, it's completely inappropriate. It's the wrong time.
My Lord, clearly, examination in chief is the context in which such a list should have been tendered, because we would have had the opportunity then to go into that list and relate it not only to the affidavit that he filed, but also to the further and better particulars. At this point, if such a list is introduced, we have no opportunity to cross-examine on that, and it is entirely inappropriate for that list to be tendered at this stage in the proceedings. My Lord, the witness actually tendered a document, if I may just refer to the exhibit number, he tendered a document which, yes, he tendered a document, it was labeled C1 to C11, list of polling stations delivered from the various categories. My Lord, if there was deleted from the various categories, if there were a further list that he wished to put in evidence, that would have been the appropriate point at which to put it in evidence.
Lord, I will not take further time to repeat what has already been said. I will support fully the objection that has been raised, my Lord.
My Lord, we are seeking to tender this list with leave of the court. The respondents have had every opportunity to cross-examine the witness on 11,842 polling stations. And therefore, It includes those that he is relying on and those he says he is not relying on. Now this list will assist the court in ascertaining the case for the petitioners, which has narrowed it down from 11,842 to 11,138. Now I refer your lordship to the proceedings of 24th April 2013 at page 16 to 17, where the question was asked in cross examination. Now you have tended in exhibit C series, in which you have indicated pink sheets you claim you have deleted from those that have been presented to court. Is that correct? Answer. That is correct. Between 12th of April, that we came in with our affidavit, there were 11,842 polling stations. Of what we are dealing with now is 11,138. Cumulatively, we are no longer relying on 704 polling stations. And this is why I keep asking that I refresh my memory to know whether some of these patients actually are relevant to the case that is before the court right now. From between we brought in the application now a total of 704 polling stations that we are no longer relying on, and the list of polling stations that are actually relying on, and this is why it ends there. And then on the next page, my Lord Adinja then asked, and have you given us a full list of the 704? It is fair that we have it. Witness, no. And if the court will allow, I will be happy to provide that list. Then Adinina, because otherwise, well, I don't know. Then the cross examination continues. So the witness did not have the opportunity then to put in this list, which my law says it will be useful to have it. Now is the opportunity to put in that list that will be useful to the court, and it takes the other side, it doesn't take them by surprise at all. You've had an opportunity to ask questions on all the polling stations that are being relied on. I will think this is the appropriate time to tender the list of 704 polling stations that the petitioners say they are not relying on.
Absolutely. Of the exhibit, they would have notified the court and notified us. They are claiming up till now that they supplied further and better particulars in respect of 11,842. Now, my lords, at this time, if a new list were admitted in evidence, we would have to have a chance to cross-examine on it. It's too late in the day for that to happen.
It is not a new list. It is contained in the 11,842 polling stations. They have had the opportunity to cross-examine the witness on these polling stations. We have assisted the court by providing this list of 704 polling stations which the witness is no longer relying on. Several times reference was made to this list by the witness during cross examination. He was not given the opportunity to tender it. And now is the time for him to tender it to the leave of the court. As I've already pointed out, your lordship thought that it would be useful to the court to have it.
Thank you. others, the various result of which, if I recall, in cross-examination, he was saying that he had cleaned it up the night, the previous day.
No.
Not this one.
No. No.
Let's hear him, and then you can come. Yes, yes.
Yes, my lord.
Was it the one?
That is so.
That's completely untrue. There are two lists here. There is one list which was the list we requested for as the matching serial number. I'm sure that is not the one.
No, that's very well. You are referring to came very, very late in the
day. The list. My understanding of the list you're talking about, this analysis that he kept facing one day to then and that week, that is what he's talking about. That's my understanding. That we are responding to, unless he's making something different.
What was standard at the time was the Exhibit C series, and also there's in cross-examination there was a revised presentation tendered. If I could just have the exhibits, I will indicate exhibits tendered by them during cross-examination, the C and then something following that, if I could just refer. Yes. My lord, exhibits A and B were the ones tendered. A was the one which is headed exhibit analysis of registered voters by region, tendered by the second petitioner and not objected to by respondents. Then exhibit B, my lord, this is the revised PowerPoint presentation in which he changes various figures. So those were the ones that were tendered at that time and nothing else.
I'm
24th April, page
17.
We are most grateful.
As your Lordship speaks.
Dr. Balmia, you say you have the list of 704 polling stations with you.
Yes, sir.
What would you like to do with it?
I'd like to tender it in, my lord.
Thank you. Now, Dr. Balbir, do you happen to have a CD version, CD-ROM version of this exhibit?
Yes, my lord, to assist the court. There's a soft version.
My lord, is this re-examination? No, this really is not re-examination. I mean, we've got high copy, we've got CD-ROM. This is not re-examination.
My lord, a document has been tendered, and I'm just eliciting.
Well, we can't authenticate that CD-ROM, I mean, at this time. When we can't admit to something that is given to anybody at this stage.
It's supposed to be a CD-ROM of the exhibit that has been tendered. It depends on what it is. So it can be, we're just assisting the court. My lord, we have CD runs for all the documents we intend tendering. If the court does not want it, we will not tender it. Then we'll move on. If we just assist in the court, and the rules also permit it, but if the court does not want the CDs, we will not tender it, and we'll go on. It's to facilitate the work of your lordship.
This is a question of evidence, so it's not protocol matter. So either you are insisting on tendering, or you are withdrawing it.
We have it, and we want to tender it to accompany the hard copy.
Mr. Editor, you see, if you recall, some were being cross-examined. This issue cropped up, and an attempt was made that the CD-ROM form part of the affidavit evidence of the petitioners, and we verified and we realized that it was not part of the exhibits attached to your exhibits at the time. So this attempt to reintroduce it at this stage, you know, is called mind-boggling.
No, my lord, this is different. This CD is just the soft version of the hard copy we have just tendered. That's all.
Oh, the soft copy of the 704, that is it.
That's all. The soft copy of the 704.
My lord, the exhibit has been tendered in hard copy. That is sufficient for the purpose of this proceeding. My lord, a CD-ROM at this stage will raise collateral issues about the authenticity of the CD-ROM in relation to the hard copy, and we do not think it is worthwhile for the court to go into that.
Of the CD-ROM, we cannot at this stage accept.
as the court pleases.
Great to my Lord.
We're grateful to your Lord too.
Now, Dr. Banyan, during cross-examination, counsel for third respondent suggested to you that your sole duplicate serial numbers category, the Exhibit P series, in fact involved half of the 6,823 polling stations, and that you have double counted and padded this category of polling stations and pin sheets simply to mislead the court and increase the number of polling stations in order to shore up your claim. Now, he asked you to provide a list of counterpart duplicate serial numbers, which you did, which was used in cross-examination, but which, however, counsel refused to tender. Now, do you have the list with you?
Yes, my lord, I have a list.
Now, what would you like to do with the list?
I would like to tender it to assist the court.
As to the nature of the list you want to send?
This is the list in response to, I believe, NDC 32, XB 32 down to.
Holding them, show them to the lawyers before it is sent, please.
Yes, ma'am. Now, it's all the documents.
We have no objection, subject to our reservation, which is this, that the sole reason for which the request was made was to match counterpart. Additional information has been provided on this, which is not part of that, and that is indicated in category column. So we do not object, subject to that being ignored as part of it. Subject to your discretion, of course. Well, the sole reason why the information was generated was to provide counterpart matching for the serial numbers. We're saying that without exception, all the lists that's provided have an additional section marked category, and that does not arise at all from the request. So while we do not object to the tendering, we'd like the court to note that subject to your fourth order, that cannot be taken into reckoning because it was not part of the information that was requested for. I don't know how you're looking to deal with it, but it's a reservation
in relation to the area map category. It's additional information that was not requested for, but that has been included in the FT.
My Lord, we also would not object to these lists being tendered, subject to two qualifications. One, my learned friend has indicated. The second one is that the witness did say that there were certain typos that he accepted. Now, those typos, we respectfully suggest, need to be corrected. He did say that the actual listing was meant to reproduce what we had. So where there's a difference in numbering, he said that those were typos. And so, my Lord, respectfully would request that those typos be corrected, because otherwise it gives a wrong impression. So subject to that, and subject to the deletion of the column headed CAT in these lists, we have no objection to the list being tendered for what they are worth.
I understand why that is now. It should be first, second, third in responding. Yes. So that he knows when to, because through due thing, that's why he's always getting up. It should be first, second, third before he responds.
No objection from our side.
The numbering of the exhibit, the exhibit numbers, the...
My Lord, these are not new documents made by us. The lawsuits were recollected. We first answered documents provided by the third respondent, and he said that we have not done it in chronological order, and we went back and then did it in chronological order and brought it. These objections being raised now, we never raised them that there's additional information. The court ruled that we're entitled to tender those documents, and therefore we have brought exactly the same documents. We have not touched anything, and now we are being confronted with new objections which were not there before. The court has ruled that we are entitled to tender these documents. They have in their possession the same documents. They have in their possession the same documents. This is what they use in cross-examining. And for them to now come and be raising issues here, it beats my mind.
The court has not ruled on this matter. That's why we have this discussion. But more important, at the time, we took the position that the matter could not be tendered through us. But we can't be taken to have forfeited any objection that we may have at the appropriate time when they are beginning to tender it. And that objection is a legitimate one. And how does he know that it did not inform our earlier objection not to have it tendered through us? Because we said the information did not emanate from us, and that they generated it. And I think it's an appropriate time to raise this matter.
My Lord, I believe the issues they've raised, they can address on it. And does it?
Very well, the objection is overruled.
We are most grateful.
Well, we didn't object.
Well,
you mean the reservation? The reservation, oh, very well.
All right. Okay. I'll apply the doctrine of memorability to the ruling. Objection overruled as regards the category section of the
entity.
There is the question of what he admitted in evidence. The second point that I raised,
I'm not clear. Yes, he mentioned stifles. Are these stifles going to be sorted out?
Yes, I didn't take Addison's plea on that. My lord, I believe whatever it is, unless you have admitted, is on the record. So when the exhibit is taken, here's the record. Everybody will see what it is.
I mean, this is to obviate that type of roundabout deep sea diving referred to. I really do not feel it is what he is objecting to. He's saying that there were typographical errors in the references to the Exodus. This was a cross-matching exercise. And as an assignment, some of the references in response to their numbers were kind of not coherent, not tally. That's what he's saying.
But, my Lord, if I may just be clear, what he admitted was that wherever he was referring to an exhibit number that we had put down, and there was a different number, it was a typo. That's what I understood him to be saying. He said it in specific reference to MVP 35, but that was, he said it was just a typo, and I asked him generally about others, and he said those were also typos. So all we're asking is, consistent with his evidence, if those typos can be corrected. I mean, this is not an objection, my Lord. I think it helps everybody for clarity on this matter.
Well, we don't know the typos he's referring to, so maybe he can assist us. I mean,
if you observe your witness in the way he was nodding in concurrence with those views, I think it's a simple exercise. You can do that subsequently. Okay.
Mark as with E1 to E7. Thank you, Master.
Now, Dr. Baumia, counsel for third respondent repeatedly put it to you that you deliberately and selectively chose only polling stations in the stronghold of the NDC where the first respondent won to ground your claim of violations, malpractices, and irregularities, and that you have done this in bad faith to pursue your ambition of becoming the vice president of this country. Now, from your analysis, are there any polling stations which were won by the first petitioner?
not arising from. There's no ambiguity here. The witness was very clear in his answers. Very, very clear. He denied it categorically, and his answer was that there was no such thing. And why are we re-examining him on a matter as clear-cut as this? This cannot be an open opportunity
My Lord, the scope of re-examination is not limited to clearing only ambiguities. When new matters come up in cross-examination, a party can be re-examined. In this instance, we are seeking to clarify an issue that goes to the credibility of the witness. To the credibility of the witness and his alleged bad faith. The impression has been created that the petitioners are relying solely on polling stations where the first respondent won. And we are seeking to clarify the issue that is not the case. It is clearly a matter that arises in re-examination when there is a distortion of facts.
Try to bring a fish in, they talk. For point of correct,
I'm sorry, my lord. How many?
The issue is how many? You didn't come.
It's about 11. It's 11 in response to.
So please pay attention to it.
Very well. My Lord, I'm most grateful. Thank you.
Very well. By majority of 6-3, answer Owusu and Iyabwaji, yes, the dissenting, the objection is sustained.
Allow me grateful.
And the court, please. Now, Dr. Babia, during cross-examination, my counsel for third respondent, he tended through you exhibit NDC 44, which is a list of 20 polling stations, which he said could not be found in petitioner's list of further and better particulars. And you answered that 11 of the polling stations were part of the further and better particulars. Now, can you tell the court the specific polling stations relating to the 11?
Well, we already answered that. We provided that in the answer to my question. It was completely unambiguous. He indicated the numbers on that list.
My Lord, I have the exhibit here, it's a list of 20. The witnesses, 11 of this are on my list. It is not indicated which 11. And that is why it is important to clarify. How can you take an objection to this?
My Lord, he indicated it, and in fact, it was on the record. He actually, in the list that we had, he had ticked them off, and we saw that. In fact, I believe the list that was sent has his ticking on that list.
Well, my Lord, he should indicate where in the record the witness listed the 11 polling stations.
44.
Our copy of the
exhibit.
Why you send your copy? There's a copy in
there. Yeah,
we have a copy from the
alright.
My recollection was that when the list was given to him, he went the next day, and when he came, he started by indicating that he had provided some on the list, and he called them out. It's on the record already.
My Lord, I think that a ruling has been given. Mr. Lita is fond of answering matters that he should not be answering. That is a matter involving counsel for third respondent. And he's gotten up and he's answered. I mean, Mr. Speaker, I thought I told, was quite capable of answering these matters.
Counsel, I mean...
And there's been a ruling on this.
I'm not fond of doing that. There was a ruling this time. I'm not fond of doing that. I thought I was just... But, I mean, let's be fair in our comments. I am part of this proceedings, and if I think there's some assistance that I can provide in terms of information, I should not be disentitled simply because, in your estimation, I'm not part of the duel. I am very much part of it.
To the note we took on the 15th May in the afternoon, the witness gave the list of the numbers concerned, and we have ticked them all on our investigation. So if we go to the 15th May, the testimony of the witness will be there on this issue in the afternoon.
We don't have any such record, and if the witness has so indicated, what harm will the court in just letting him repeat the list? We don't have any record of it.
My Lord, I think... Numbers
2, 3, 5, 7, 8, 11, 12, 13, 15,
16, and 17. Are those correct 10 points? These are the ones he said were retained.
The 11 that were retained?
Yes.
Your Lordship has a record of that?
Yes. Yeah, that I read out. Not from my mind, from the record.
Very well. Yes. Well, then we will not press. It's a record. Lordship has a record of it, we will not press it. Except that maybe if it could be ticked on the exhibit, then it will be clear.
Well, but at the time it was turned out he didn't take it on the exit. So are you seeing the report? Yes,
that is why if it can be ticked, that is why we thought that the list that we'll provide will complement it.
The list as standard was not ticked by him. It was a roll call he lettered out.
I thought that our list will complement the exhibit in showing clearly. And nothing will be lost if we tender the list. I'm saying nothing will be lost if we tender our list, which will complement the exhibit, which is in evidence.
I mean, it is getting out of hand.
What do you object to everything?
Very well, your question is overruled.
My suggestion?
Whatever. it came in the question of, I mean, the form of question under cross-examination, so and so. You excluded 11 from NGC protocol. Which of them are they? That's what we are. That's what the objection related to.
Very well. Now, Dr. Bamia, you have told this court during cross examination. Again, my counsel for third respondent, that you have had to make some changes in categorization in respect of some of the 11,138 polling stations you are relying on as a result of further quality control and scrutiny. Now, are you able to tell the court which polling stations are involved in this recategorization?
Yes, my lord.
Objection.
Formulate your question, we'll get it clearly down, and then...
During cross-examination by counsel for third respondent, witness explained that he has had to make changes to some to the categorization of some of the polling stations he was relying on as a result of quality control and further scrutiny. And the question is if he's able to tell the court which polling stations have undergone recategorization.
Have not been amended. And the petitioner's testimony in respect of whatever quality control he claims to have done was specific and it is not open to him now in re-examination to seek from the petitioner questions about changes in the category which are set out not only in paragraphs 44 to 67 of the affidavit but also in the petition. If your lordships were to allow such a reopening of this matter again with respect, that would require us to cross-examine on these changes.
Lord, respectfully, we have fashioned our cross-examination based on documentation that had been provided to us. Now, if after that, and that cross-examination, and while the case is going on, he changes his mind about categorization and is seeking to lead evidence in respect of that and that re-examination, our case is completely prejudiced. In fact, it will reopen this case entirely.
My lords, we associate ourselves to the objection raised, brother.
My lords, we are referring to evidence that has already gone in. If the evidence is at variance with the pleadings can be brought in line with the evidence. Several times during cross-examination, the witness indicated that certain polling stations have been mislabeled or have been wrongly categorized. He sought permission to refresh his memory and to refer to his analysis so many times, and that opportunity was denied him. This is a time for us to clear the ambiguity that has been created as a result of these questions that were asked. The violations that the witness spoke about are evident on the face of the pink sheets, and categorization, miscategorization, and mislabeling will not affect the violations that are evident on the face of the pink sheets. We are therefore seeking the leave of this court for this clarification to be made.
My lord, the last statement of my learned friend to the effect that the violations are on the face of the pink sheet should settle this matter as a matter of law, because he is saying that what he is now seeking to ask about is actually on the face of the pink sheet, and that has been their case. And what we are saying with respect is that at this stage, the pleadings have not been amended.
Respectfully, categorization is so essential to their case that seeking to amend that at this time when cross-examination is completed amounts to changing their case completely. That categorization is so fundamental to the cases they are making. And the categorization became a moving goal post during cross-examination. And then at this time, they want to completely change the fundamental basis of their case with that categorization. It's an amazing proposition indeed. I think it should be soundly rejected.
My Lord, we're not changing the nature of our case. This miscategorization and mislabel was as a result of the huge documentation that the petitioners had to deal with. In the further and better particulars, clear details are given as to the violations in every polling station. And we are sticking to that. And as we said, the violations are evident on the face of the petition. It is not the categorization or the labeling that will change these violations. Thank you.
That's about the categories of malpractices, isn't it?
Yes, my lord.
Tend to be, you know, difficult, but there are no exhibit numbers on any of these things. They're always supposed to be doing that. The exhibit numbers changed because of the cross examinations from Catholic. So there should be the exhibit numbers that are changing. They are not even here. We have a document without any exhibit numbers at all, being moved from one category to the other. I don't know how that does.
Respectfully, we understood your ruling to relate to a question that was asked before this list was tendered. We would respectfully object to this list. It has no exhibit numbers either in respect of the new category or the old category. And my lords, this has no relationship to any of the cross-examination that was conducted. This is just an attempt to smuggle in some information that should have probably been part of the examination in chief, and else, this is not the way that we can conduct these proceedings. I mean, exhibit numbers were used in the cross-examination at every point. Every list that we submitted had an exhibit number, and we cannot, with this sort of unclarity, we cannot proceed in any meaningful way. Especially when it's being done in re-examination.
You know, I spoke my learned colleague on this. If I understand what had happened, when the polling station was mentioned and he said there was duplication, he said, oh, we used it only once, we moved it to this category. And therefore, my understanding is that any list would relate to the cross-examination that was given, answers that were given to those cross-examination in relation to pink sheets. There is absolutely nothing on this to indicate where these documents are coming from, what the exhibit numbers are. Because, my Lord, if this were admitted in and we now want to find another duplication, how would we find it? Because that's the essence of the cross-examination, that there be multiple duplications. So are they obscuring the fact that we could find
multiplication out of whatever they've done. I mean, it's completely prejudicial. And prejudice is substantial ground that sometimes overrides relevance. Yes, my lord. Yes, my lord. No, the court ruled on a question, not on the tendering of the document. We are saying that this document does not relate to the order that was made in relation to the this. It's completely divorced from it. There's nothing connecting it to the ordered ruling that was made in relation to the objection, to the question. Even if it's relevant, it is extremely prejudicial.
My Lord, this issue has been ruled on by the court. It will amount to re-arguing the same old point. We talked of recategorization. This is a list which shows the new category and the old category, the region, the constituency, the polling station code, serial number. I mean, I don't know what else they want to be there. We said that we are showing the recategorization, and that is exactly what has been done in this document. We have argued at length on this. Your lordship will go in, you come back, you've ruled on it. They are still taking up objection to it. It will be endless.
My lord, is the exhibit numbers that are recategorized? There's no exhibit number.
I thought your question was, which polling stations are affected by your listing?
Recategorization.
Yes.
That is
so. It is not the whole of the thing sheet that they are talking of.
No.
So as he is saying, at least you must indicate the exhibit and the polling stations which have been moved from one category to another.
Well, that is what it shows. That is what it does. Yes. and we wish to turn that through the witness. We have indicated the change in categorization. We can't maintain the old exhibit numbers because the category has changed. And this is what we have indicated on this document. The exhibit
Thank you.
If the court would like us to put the old exhibit numbers in it, we will do that.
We took copious notes on the cross-examination regarding duplication, triplication, quadruplication. And if we are to be faced with a document without the exhibit numbers, it will pose a problem for us, my Lord. So if they offered to supply the exhibit numbers, my Lord, that might clarify things for us. Because to be faced, all the exhibits so far have had exhibit numbers listed. And this will be the first one. So we are expressing also our concern on this aspect.
There's an objection on the table, and my Lord, respectfully, these are people's votes we are talking about. Once we are talking about exhibits, recategorization, the underlying issue is about how many votes should be allowed, and that is a serious issue, and we think that we should have some indication. Which, may I counsel?
We are talking about this document. The court has ruled on the issue of the recategorization.
The court hasn't ruled, and I'm on my feet, counsel, my feet. If they want to withdraw it, they can withdraw it and bring a proper decision. But we need to know which exhibits they are moving. We definitely need to. If this is supposed to assist the court, it doesn't assist the court at all.
By unanimous decision, the objection is sustained.
Allah, we are very grateful.
My Lord, so what does that mean? That we have to provide the exhibit numbers.
When an exhibit is tendered rejected, it has to be marked tendered rejected, marked up.
My Lord, we made the offer to put in the exhibits.
That one.
Well, this court has ruled that we can ask these questions, and we have done it. If there's any dissatisfaction with the manner in which it has been done, it can be corrected, because this will amount to overruling your own earlier ruling, which gave us a lie.
At all. We allowed you to follow suit properly. You didn't follow properly.
We're talking of substantial justice here. This court has said that we can give evidence on the recategorization. And there's an issue about exhibit numbers. We're praying that the court gives us leave so that tomorrow we will bring another list with the exhibit numbers. This is in the interest of justice.
My lords, respectfully, the petitioners, counsel for the petitioners, had the opportunity to tender whatever he wanted to tender. We raised an objection. It has been sustained, and if he had indicated before lunch that he's ending his cross-examination, it's getting late in the day. But my lord, I think what is being done here, I mean, we're not in the world of Houdini here.
And I do not think that we should entertain these shuffling of things, you know, without any specific references. And that's what your lordships have ruled.
Yes, well, my lord, we are seeking leave to come back tomorrow, first thing in the morning, to tender a document to the exhibit numbers. As regards the recategorization, this court has ruled, and has ruled that we can give evidence on that.
Apart from this, do you have any further questions?
Re-examination? Subject to this, we will end our re-examination. Subject to retendering the list of recategorization which this court has given us, to go ahead.
Well, I think maybe you took a bad gamble.
Evidence of the recategorization as it is now. We have, through the back door, been denied that right. The same right given to us has been taken away.
My Lord.
And therefore, we cannot say that we have ended re-examination.
My Lord,
well, our view is that is ended because your last question was about this tendering. And the ruling on it, you know, closes the matter. It's a subject to that matter of tendering the document, which we have ruled on. And so, for us,
in view of the present ruling, we think that it's only fair that we are allowed, in the interest of justice, to carry on with our re-examination, unless, again, the court is curtailing that right of us to do the re-examination. Are we to take it that our re-examination has been curtailed by the court?
Mr. Addison, we have ruled that following our understanding of what you did in your presence, you said you had just one last question.
No, I didn't say I had one last. I said the subject to the ruling of the court.
Yes, and we have
the court ruled in our favor, and now somehow, through the back door, that ruling has been negated.
Through the back door.
That ruling has been negated.
What
ruling? That ruling, the court gave us the right to go on with leading evidence of recategorization, has somehow been negated.
Look, I think that we've tried to be very tolerant, but we cannot take dictation from the bar. We can't take dictation from the bar. And this matter, when I even noticed you later, and I was wondering why you are still standing, and then you added this bit about, you know, you could supply the numbers later. We all heard you. At that time, the views were advanced, leaving about just two or three. And then the rest came in, also sustaining. And I announced the ruling. And
Lord, the matter. We are not dictating to the bench. We are asking for leave from the court. If this document has been refused to go in, we would like to need further evidence on the issue of the recategorization, because the document that we're going to be tendered in support of our case has been refused now.
That's all we are asking for. We're not dictating to the bench. All we are seeking to do is keep of the court so we can go
back. Mr. Adesanya, we have ruled, we have understood all that you have said. And we have explained to you that if you had thought, if you had retreated, we would have probably considered that. But you did not.
So the court
and
is
the ruling
our re-examination.
And that terminates.
The court is curtailing our re-examination.
We have not curtailed, we have gone according to your undertaking as regards the re-examination. And we have closed it in accordance with how you undertook it and the undertaking you gave to the bench.
My lord, respectfully, if may we respectfully ask that the document be marked rejected? We haven't had the marking on the document as R. The document that was rejected.
Lord, we are all in this court and documents that have been rejected.